Hello, and welcome to KDAB News, the monthly update for professionals working with Qt, C++, and 3D technologies. I'm Robert Brock with this special edition from Berlin's Qt World Summit 2023. This episode, the topics are three interviews, CXX Qt 0.6 release, tip of the month, announcements, and resources. Hello, Volker, and thank you for joining me.
Hi, Robert. Nice to meet you. Nice to be here.
So we're here at Qt World Summit 2023, and it really looks like live events are back in full swing.
Absolutely, yeah. It's great to see so many people, so many customers, so many partners, so many colleagues, so many community members for the first time in a long time.
Yeah, it's getting quite full. So earlier today, you were on stage for the Qt Roadmap keynote. Do you have any moments from that that you're looking forward to, or any that you think stand out more than others?
I think on the Qt roadmap, the things that excite me most are what we can still do for UI developers, for UI builders. I think the constant questions that we are getting around, should we use Qt Quick? Should we use Qt Widgets? I'm looking forward to this no longer being a question, because Qt Quick is really there. Qt Quick is really going to be a first-class toolkit for the desktop, for the mobile, or embedded. People don't have to make that decision anymore. But also what we talked about, use Qt Quick together with your widget application. Like I mentioned in the morning keynote, we know that there are still a couple of rough edges, getting all of that streamlined so that people don't have to fear anymore that they are losing quality, that they are losing some aspect of their application, user interface or user experience when they are doing that. Getting us to that point, that will be a milestone for Qt, I think.
Perfect. Thank you, Volker, for your time.
Thank you very much.
So, hi, Maurice. Thank you for joining me again on KDAB News.
Nice to see you again.
And so we're here today at Qt World Summit 2023. You've just come off stage recently after doing the Qt Roadmap keynote. Do you have anything you're looking forward to from the keynote, or any favorite parts?
I think overall the interesting part is when you talk about the roadmap and the future, how software development in itself is evolving. We were mentioning like how Qt is moving towards an open tool, open framework, etc. And I think it's really one of the crucial aspects, because it's not only about C++ or other languages, other frameworks, other tool sets, native Qt, how does it all come together? And I think Qt can really be the binding factor in that for UI solution and getting all the technologies together into a proper and a long-lasting solution when out of that. So that's really like the target from my end.
Perfect. Well, thank you very much for your time.
Thanks for having us.
We are here at the Qt World Summit 2023 in Berlin. I'm joined by Christoph Hennersberger, who is the CTO of LumaVision, a very fascinating company with a great product that we've been working with for a few years now. We are just off the stage, literally, of our customer showcase keynote here at the event. And I'm taking the opportunity to ask some additional questions, if that's okay.
Yeah.
So could you, for our viewers, very quickly, and I know that's very hard, summarize what you guys do with Qt?
With Qt, so we're developing an imaging system, and we've used Qt as a front-end platform from the start for anything front-end, but then also for rendering tasks. That's really the major focus. I think there's a lot more detail, but on a very high level, that's what we do with Qt.
Awesome, yep. So how's it to be at a Qt event, I think, for the first time for you?
First time, yeah. I saw that the last couple of years were all remote, so it's actually great in person. It's actually quite an interesting vibe here. Lots of relevant developers also for our audiences, and jointly. So it's great spirit. Some very interesting talks so far, and hopefully we'll continue the same way.
Yeah, I think there were some people in the audience who are facing very similar challenges as you. So
I mean, we're a startup, and I think there's many startups out there, and that's quite key to maybe give some best practices, learnings in engagement with KDAB. I think there have been learnings as well, but I think it has been quite a good journey. Not everything else has been perfect for us. It's always a bumpy ride, but it's quite exciting.
Cool. So if people want to learn more from you or from us, is there a way to get in touch with you?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, you can use all the common portals. Hopefully have some nice discussions here today, but then use LinkedIn, use our website, lumavision.com. Just approach me, approach us. I think we're all reachable, and it's actually quite open, and always happy to just give an opinion if there's questions, or of course if people want to join the company, also very interested.
Yeah, all right. Thank you very much.
So we're here at Qt DevCon day two, and I'm here with Josef. Hi Josef.
Nice to meet you.
So what is it you are currently focused on?
I'm focused to bring a 3D hardware and 3D workflows to a very wide spectrum of applications. And I figured out that simple from 20 years back, the developer forgot the user in front of a stereo vision of a VR environment, that they used the easiest to control tools and mouse cursor with your touchpad or with your mouse. And this is since 2.5 years, I'm focused to bring in examples to demonstrate that very easy, the software vendor can take the control of the mouse cursor, and then stereo have really a totally different options and benefits, because humans want to grab in the depth and pick things, and that's so intuitive. That's my story at the moment.
Version 0.6 of CXXQt, the Rust bindings for Qt, has been released. This version brings a new API that will be used for a future stable 1.0 release. Additionally, support for Qt enums, signal connections within Rust, and building QML modules has been added. Read more in the release blog linked below. Feel free to try out the API to help find any missing gaps before the stable 1.0 release. A while back, KDAB published a series of blogs that explained using VS Code for Qt applications, and recently, we added two more articles. Our colleagues Nicolas Arnaud-Cormo and Sergio Martins have created the fastest way to get going for Qt developers who want to use the world's best C++ UX framework with the powerful VS Code IDE. By putting most of the necessary ingredients into CMake, it really trims down what's necessary to get things working. The basic setup is tested on Windows, Mac, and Linux computers. The blog linked below guides you through all the steps to set it up. The thing that makes VS Code an amazing productivity tool is that you can add all kinds of extensions to it, tools to help you write, document, and debug code. While the C, C++ extensions from Microsoft and KlangD do many of the same things, they each have individual strong suits. The second article explains why you should use both C++ extensions and how you set them up. The short answer is that having both will maximize your productivity in every situation. Read the blog for more details. Among the few events happening in December, there is the German Embedded Software Engineering Congress, ESE, happening from the 4th to the 8th of December in Sindelfingen near Stuttgart. It offers a broad variety of talks, most of them in German, with a handful in English. In addition, on the 1st of December, there is a free online pre-conference, also with German and English presentations. You can find out more on the conference website linked below. Are you planning to improve your developer skills in 2024? We have recently launched a new website for the training courses we have on offer, and have added new course dates for the next year to the schedule. New in stock are the training courses for Rust that we offer in collaboration with the leading Rust experts, Ferris Systems. Go check it out on training.kdab.com. As you might have noticed if you follow our channel regularly, Jesper started a new tutorial series, Introduction to Qt Widgets. Here he is to tell us a bit more about it.
Well, you know, we can all learn. We should all learn throughout life. And we put out the QML training videos a few years ago, and that was a huge success. But being the widget guy in KDAB nowadays, I thought that we should put out the Qt widget training too. So we started doing that. Well, you know, life happens sometimes. I have other things to do in KDAB besides just putting out YouTube videos. So it actually takes me quite a bit of time making sure that the content is accurate in these videos. So I can't do this for months and months. So I'll cherry pick it in between other things I do in KDAB. And we put them out in logical units so that it doesn't end up being five videos and then we just stop right before it's getting really interesting in some related areas. So we group them in modules and then I'll catch up and re-release it as soon as I'm done. That's a good question, actually. And now, there's at least going to be five modules by now. I've recorded mentally at least three modules already. And there's going to be two more in our core training material, but we also plan to put out a lot of our supplementary topics. And let me just give you an example. Qt 6 did it. Don't know much about that. I don't think I ever taught it in training once, but we're going to put that out too. And that's going to require a bit of preparation. We're going to put that out. It might be two or three episodes on just Qt 6 edit. And then we'll put that out as a module. And then we'll focus on one of the other supplementary topics. And we've got a lot of those. So I have prerequisite inside of KDAP set. I'm going to put out 100 episodes. Let's see if that's going to be true. But I think we're going to be close.
And last but not least, KDAB has published a new white paper in the Software Development Best Practices series, Software Updates Outside the App Store. When building an application distributed through the Google or Apple App Stores, much of the heavy lifting in delivering updates is handled for you. However, there are many circumstances where these consumer app stores don't apply. Embedded devices, industrial desktop applications, and dedicated use tablets, among others. If you're building one of these systems, your software will naturally live outside of these app stores. Our paper discusses how you design and build a system that can effectively deliver and update your software. Thank you for watching. Stay safe and feel free to share any questions or feedback below the video. I'll see you next time.